This is The Orange Couch.
I'm Mark.
I'm Amanda.
And this is Mad Men, Season 5, Episode 4, Mystery Date.
He's here! My mystery date!
Mystery date, are you ready for your mystery date? Don't be late, it would be great. Open the door for your mystery date.
It's Mystery Date, the thrilling new Milton Bradley game of romance and mystery that's just for you. And you. And you. And you. Mystery Date, will you be ready for swimming?
And we have an Orange Couch surprise of our own. Amanda is traveling this week, so I am flying solo. But rest assured, her fingerprints are all over this. So, in an episode called Mystery Date, I guess it's no surprise that this episode is all about secrets, but it's also about the looming shadow of male violence and the complicated feelings that 1966 society, and I guess our own really, have about it. First, though, the secrets. This is embodied by the ad Michael first pitches to Don.
A woman and her secrets. Oh, the things she'll never tell. Like how long it took her to get ready, or the reason she's smiling.
We find out all sorts of little surprises in this episode. Don's got one. Roger's got one, which costs him another $410, the third time in 3 weeks that we have seen him pull cash out of his pocket to solve his problems.
The work is $10. The lie is extra.
Incredible.
Don gets a surprise, kind of.
Get in here.
And Joan definitely gets one when she learns Greg's extended second tour wasn't exactly the Army's idea, but his.
He didn't tell you about it. Of course not.
What is she talking about? Did you have a say in this?
Really, though, it's the second ad that Michael pitches, the one he really wanted to sell, that gets to the heart of the episode.
She knows she's not safe, but she doesn't care. I guess we know in the end, she wants to be caught.
So Michael's pitch is about the sexualization and the titillation of the threat, that lurking possibility of male violence. And this episode is actually a fascinating examination of that very thing. First, we see the communal thrill of looking at those two awful-to-print pics of Richard Speck's murder of those eight nurses in Chicago. Everyone but Michael has to look. Michael, of course, being the one who seemed to recognize the power of it so much that he built his super-secret little sabotage pitch around it. We also have Dawn's fear of traveling alone at night. The fear and excitement cocktail that Sally and Pauline seem to share as they bond in that haunted house of Betty's dreams. And then, of course, we have this.
Sick.
Now, my first reaction was, what the hell? Followed mostly by irritation at the cliched way they managed to show how much Don wants to kill that dark side of himself. But I guess, in the context of this episode, I can live with the ham-fistery, especially because that build-up to it made us think this episode had to do with Don and Megan's relationship, when, in another surprise, it was actually about Jones.
It's done.
Well, you can't make a decision like that without me, and you have never understood that!
Now, if you're anything like me, and probably, I guess, I don't know, 90% of other Mad Men viewers, you probably thought Greg was as good as dead when he shipped off. But that really would have been the kind of deus ex machina that Mad Men does generally seem to avoid. Instead, we get to deal with the dark cloud that has hung over this marriage, the one we all thought was swept under the rug a couple seasons ago.
The Army makes me feel like a good man.
You're not a good man. You never were. Even before we were married, and you know what I'm talking about.
Joan was raped, and she reminds us that for all the ways that our culture fantasizes about fear and violence, for all the ways that it's packaged and sold in a Michael Ginsburg special, that the reality of it is horrible and unforgettable. In an interesting juxtaposition, the only person who fears a female act of violence is Peggy. As they drink, Peggy tries to equate her life and experience with Dawn's, not the first time that she's tried to compare herself to the struggles of African Americans in the series, but with that one look, Peggy shows everyone, including herself, why she can't even begin to grasp some of the obstacles that Dawn faces every single day. And of course, the fear that she has, however momentary it might have been or whatever, it's completely unfounded. This season seems like it's shaping up to be about the transfer of power from one generation to the next culturally, from Dawn to Megan in a way he never would have conceived of with Betty, from Roger to Pete, we've seen that already, and in one of the strangest moves, from maybe Dawn to Michael. On the surface, this moment seemed like blind hubris.
You know you almost got fired just now.
I don't think you're right about that.
But the truth is that Michael just sold two ideas in like 5 minutes, and the client called him a genius in between. This dude is not gunning for Peggy like I thought. This dude is gunning for Dawn, and he is not the least bit worried about anyone getting in the way, especially Dawn. I'm not exactly sure where they're going with Michael, but I have a feeling we're going to be surprised where he winds up at the end of the season. So Joan is single. Such a great development, except for the part where I'm dreading Roger's inevitable, awful reaction to this news. In the meantime, we'll see you next week on the Orange Couch.